Die Heritage Project is die Holocaust Centrum in Kaapstad se jongste onderneming. Een massieve project met die oogmerk om artefakte wat behou geblei het van die Joodse mensenslachting gedurende die Tweede Wereldoorlog van niets af te kategoriseer, een inventaris daarvan te maak en later in digitale vorm aan navorsers en die publiek beskikbaar te stel.
We're currently in the process of creating an inventory so that we know exactly what we've got. With this, we can kind of put together the fragments of what we see on the surface and really bring out the stories, the hidden stories that are actually submerged in these artifacts. What's really interesting about this is currency that was printed in concentration camps and ghettos, which really reflects the extent to which this process of separation was in place. And I think often there's perhaps, it's possible for people to forget just how isolated Jews in ghettos were. These are lists of survivors coming from different places. So for example, this is a list of Polish Jewish refugees. And to actually say, for example, this is just one list. So often this list, which is just 4 pages, wouldn't have been together. We're really focusing on preserving this material, digitizing the material so it doesn't have to be handled, but ultimately the process of digitization will enable this material to be accessed by researchers and members of the public. You know, this really documents for us how real the threat of Nazism was worldwide, and I suppose the threat that was felt in South Africa. This is a songbook created by a group of Germans interned in Leeuwkop prison in South Africa during the war. Can I turn?
Yeah.
If you see on the inside front page, there's actually letters, notes, signed by everyone as one would a songbook. And the song contains quite a lot of, the songs are actually quite nationalistic, pro-Nazi.
The idea is really, once we're able to, we'd like to start digitizing material. And in the long run, we're hoping to do a project that will focus not only on the artifacts, but on, you know, the relationship of Nazi Germany as a racial state to apartheid in South Africa as a racial state. And, you know, archive and understanding the history of prejudice and racial discrimination, you know, can only assist within our human rights-based culture, or in creating and strengthening a human rights-based culture.